Welcome to Backbends for Flexibility. My name is Patricia Becker, and I am going to teach you how to move safely through backbends from beginning to a little bit more intermediate and advanced. When I first started doing yoga and started practicing some backbend poses, sometimes I got a little bit of pain in my lower back. Sometimes I got a lot of pain in my lower back. It eventually went away. But I didn't understand good principles how to stay in alignment and do backbends safely. So when done correctly, they're going to be challenging, and we like a little bit of challenge, and they should be comfortable. So if they're not comfortable or something's wrong, stop, reassess, ask me a question, comment in the section below, or you can get a hold of me through my website. So backbends are very exhilarating. They're very heart opening. We call them the natural antidepressant because they just open everything up. So I'd like you to take a comfortable seat. Take your sit bones in, back, and apart. Take your glute muscles apart. Lift up through your spine. Draw your shoulders back. And please just take a couple of slow, deep breaths, settling into your body. As we begin this practice, take a moment and spend time enjoying creating greater flexibility and mobility in your back. Before we begin, I have to give you a warning. This class and all these Yoga for Health and Joy classes can actually lead to health and joy. Just a reminder. So please take your left hand to your right knee and prop up your spine behind you and turn over, turn from your belly, and we're just going to loosen up the spine with a nice gentle twist before we dive into our back bends. Inhale through center. Take your right hand on your left knee, prop up your spine, turn from your belly, grow tall through the top of your head. And then inhale through center. Now interlace your hands behind your back. Curl your shoulders up and back. Curl the bottom tips of your shoulder blades up behind your heart. And here we have a little bit of upper back, baby back bend. Right here we're beginning. And it feels so good to open up our chest like this. And release. So much of what we're doing during our day, we're driving, we're carrying our kids, we're lifting things, we're on our computers, we're like this. So back bends are very exhilarating. And once you start getting into the groove, you might find them addictive. So we're going to begin again on our bellies. So please come to your belly. And we're going to do a pose called Cobra Pose or Bhujangasana. So place your fingertips, spread them nice and wide, and make sure you root down through the mound of your index finger. Squeeze your legs together and please pull your belly forward. Pull your shoulders back and heart up. Take the sides of your throat back. And your shoulder blades coming up behind your heart to lift up your heart. This is an upper back back bend. That's what we want to focus on, the upper back. Take a couple of slow, deep breaths. And you're pressing your fingers down, your hands down to help you pull your belly forward or your shoulders back even more. And I'm pressing my legs down. And exhale, come down nice and easy. Now we're going to do Shalabhasana. This is a very easy, basic, strengthening back bend. So you curl your shoulder blades up behind your, up and interlace your hands behind your back, the way we did sitting. Curl your shoulders up, shoulder blades behind your heart. And lift everything up. And you can even look up. Now, release a little bit, stop efforting so much. Then re-engage and lift up a little higher. And come on down. You can make a pillow with your hands and turn your head to the side and rest. These belly back bends are very safe. This is the way we started to move when we were babies. This is how we started to strengthen our bodies so that we can slowly stand up and move. Once is good, twice is better. So this time, please interlace your hands the opposite way, your non-dominant finger behind. You can squeeze and squeeze the heels of your hands together. Curl your shoulders up and back, shoulder blades behind your heart. Squeeze your legs together, and then lift everything up. If you can get it up, get it up. And then we'll release a little bit, re-engage the muscles, and come up a little higher. And come on down. Interlace your hands and turn your head to the other side. Or you can just make a pillow with your hands. You can turn your head to the other direction. And these belly back bends, in addition to be very safe and strengthening to your back and opening to your upper back and your chest, they're also the great equalizer of all yoga poses, because no matter if you've been doing yoga for 30 years or 3 days, you can only get up off the ground so much. So let's do it again. I like to call this pose Superman or Superwoman. So we'll have our hands out like this. We'll curl the shoulders up, shoulder blades behind the heart, and everything lifted up, 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 up. And come down a little bit, and then come up a little bit more. And for bonus points, you can turn up the corners of your mouth into a smile. And come on down. Pillow with your hands and turn your head to the other side. And drink in the vitality that you're creating. And now come on up to your forearms. Press your arms down. Pull your belly forward. Draw your shoulders back. And we're going to do Ekapadabekasana. So we'll take our left arm parallel with the front of your mat. Bend your right leg. Reach around. Look for your foot. Get a hold of the top of your foot on the inside. And then turn your torso back to the front. Push your foot away from you. Give your quadricep muscles a stretch. You can stay right here, or if you've got open quadricep muscles, you can start taking your heel towards your outer hip, and you can maybe even start turning your fingers towards your toes, taking your elbow up and taking a little bit deeper. If you want, you can take your foot all the way to the mat. I can't. Maybe some people can. I don't know. I know one person can. But it's a nice quadricep stretch. Find the place that's good for you. And then we'll slowly release. It's good to have your quadriceps engaged and open to help you open your back bends. Right arm parallel with the short side of your mat. Bend your left leg, reach around, get a hold of the top of your foot. Make sure your legs are parallel behind you, please. And then push your foot away, lift your heart and chest up. Maybe that's just right for you, or maybe you want to take it a little bit deeper. Wherever you are, it's very important. Not too many things in yoga are important. Well, maybe they are. But anyway, you need to keep your thighs parallel behind you to protect your back. I love quadricep stretches. And then we'll slowly come on down. Okay, now we're going to do bow pose. So we're going to come on down. Now we're going to bend both legs. Flare your toes, reach around, get a hold of your ankles on this variation. And then press your knees down so your groins lift up. This helps you make sure that you have your thighs parallel behind you. And then tailbone down and push your thighs, calves away from you, chins away, and then lift up. Curl your shoulder blades up behind your heart. And come on down. And back bends take a lot of energy, so it's good to take a few breaths in between each one and feel. Feel if you need to make any adjustments, any alignments. Like I said, if you have any questions, please feel free to contact me on my website or in the comment section. I'm happy to help you. Now we'll do another one. This time, instead of getting hold of the ankles, we're going to take hold of the tops of the feet. And shoulders up, shoulder blades behind your heart. And now we're going to kick everything up. So instead of having the thighs down, we'll kick everything up. And it always helps to look up a little bit, sides of your throat back. And you want to feel it in your upper back. Now, just for the fun of it, we'll roll to the side and still do a back bend. And then we'll come up, and then we'll roll to the other side. There we go. And we'll kick straight up through center. Come on down, make a pillow. And this time, if you'd like, you can rest your forehead right on your hands. Slow, even breathing. Feel the vitality pulsing through you. Okay, please bring your hands alongside your chest, tuck your toes, and we're gonna take a little child's pose. Take your knees apart, big toes together, and you can stretch your arms out. You can stretch, stretch, stretch like this. Keep pressing your hips back and giving your back traction. You can keep your forehead, your ears in line with your arms, or if you'd like to calm down in your child's pose, rest your forehead down on your mat. And then we'll stretch ourselves out into Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Stretch it out. So our lower back is getting a nice stretch out. Lift up your belly button towards your spine. Sit bones up to the sky. And then we'll bend our knees and slowly walk up to the top of the mat. And we'll take Malasana Garland Pose. We'll sit down. I'm having my feet together here in this Malasana Garland Pose. You can also take your feet further apart if you need to. This is the way a lot of people sit in the world, doing cooking, doing a lot of things. They have open hips. So for us, we can snuggle our shoulders up behind our legs, push your tailbone down and lift your heart up. I like to move side to side a little bit. And then, so close, we'll sit down. Okay. We're going to do a pose called Purvottanasana. It's a stretch for the east side of the body. Your fingertips face your toe tips. And you draw your shoulders back. Shoulder blades lift your heart up. Nice, easy back bend here. Lift your hips up. Shoulders back. And you have to lift up your heart, too. And your chin draws in slightly. You don't have your neck head drop down. You can take it down deliberately if you need to, if you'd like to. Just don't want it to drop. And you can stay here, or you can stretch your left leg long. And then, of course, the other one, too. And we'll sit down. Give yourself a hug. You deserve it. Round your back, take your belly button back, and then arch your back. And then stretch your legs out. We're going to do Purvottanasana again. So you can do it the same way with your knees bent, or if you'd like to try this way, draw your shoulders back, press your arms down, and bottoms up. Parvottanasana. Or it's also, you could call it a plank pose, opposite of the other one we're used to doing. And then come on down. And now we're going to do bridge pose, Setubandha. This is a great pose. It's nice and basic and easy. I'm going to teach you how to get into it, the basic from the beginning. So you bring your arms up like robot, like you're a robot. You press your upper arms down, you press your shoulders down, and the back of your head rests down, and you want to feel a curve in your neck. And then you press your arms down, shoulders down, feet down. And again, lift your hips up, bottoms up. This is our yoga happy hour, yoga happy half hour. Well, if you do two of the shows, it's a full hour. So here we go, bridge pose, Setubandha Shavasana. So there's a lot of variations on this. This is where you begin, which is great. So if you're feeling comfortable here and you'd like to try it a little bit further, you can pick up one shoulder and roll your arm under. This gives you extra lift in your upper chest, and then the other one, and then you can interlace your hands, take the heels of your hand together perhaps, and then re-engage everything. Your heart lifts up towards your chin, but your chin moves away slightly so that you can keep breathing. Don't want to choke off your throat. And release your hands, come down, and feel. Connect with your breath. You should be feeling very exhilarated by now. These are so energizing. You know, if you just get tired during your day and you do a few of these back bends, do part of this class or do the whole class, it's going to turn your whole day around. So I'm going to show you another fun variation with a yoga strap. So I'm going to wrap this yoga strap around our ankles. It's fun to have yoga toys to play with. So we're going to hold on to the strap. You can hold on to wherever it's comfortable for you. Press your feet down. Get a good grip of the strap and lift your bottoms up, shoulders down, and then again, press your hips down. And then you can use the strap to help you get in a little bit more, to get a little bit more mobility in your upper back. And then come on down, take a rest. So the key with back bends, so you don't feel pain like I did when I was doing them incorrectly, is your lower back. You want to imagine, you know, your kidneys are back here on your lower back. Imagine your kidneys are like your party balloons, and they're filling up with oxygen or hydrogen. So they're filling up. So now we're ready for Urdhva Dhanurasana. So we're going to place our hands alongside here. Well, you could start here from bridge pose like this. So you can do bridge pose again if you'd like, or you can take your hands alongside your ears, take them out pretty far, elbows straight up, and my hips are up, and then I'm going to press down through my feet and come up to the top of my head. And I'm going to re-engage my shoulders, because if I'm like this, I can't really get up too good. So I'm going to push my shoulders back, lift my, roll more to my forehead, and then lift up from the back of my heart and from my feet. That's a big pose. And when I first started doing these poses, I thought, I can't do that pose. I thought, my body just can't do it. It's really nice that these other people that I'm seeing in the class can do it, but my body's not going to be able to do it. And I was lying down trying to do it, and I couldn't get up, and I was looking over there, and I saw some woman that was quite a bit older than me, and she did it. And in that moment, I said, if her body can do it, this body kept doing it. So I just kept listening to the instructions. It's all about listening and paying attention to your body and proper instructions. So then, you can keep growing the pose. As long as we live, there's always more to do in the yoga poses. It's a beautiful journey. It never ends, just like life. Okay, so now we're gonna do something a little bit fun. So we're gonna roll our, press our shoulders down. We're gonna do Urdhva Dhanurasana again. I'm gonna come up to the top of my head just to re-engage. I can pop right up if I want, but I feel like this is better. And then push up. And then you can walk in a little bit more. Now I'm gonna press down through my right leg, bend my left knee in, and take that leg straight up. It's fun. It just takes practice. Practice, practice, practice. Okay. Now, we will stretch out our legs. Or actually, excuse me, bend your legs. So we've been compressing our lower back. I don't want you to bend it the other way. I want you to just give it traction. So place your hands on your thighs. Push your thighs away from you. Take your lower back to your mat. Just push your thighs away. Nice traction in your back. Okay, now we'll give it a little more traction. Keep your left foot rooted down. Pick up your right leg, interlace your hands behind the belly of your right hamstring. The belly's the middle, so not here and not here, right in the middle. And then push your thigh away from you. And then this is also giving your lower back traction. A little bit of a balancing act. You can keep your foot, your leg bent, or stretch your right foot and pretend like you're trying to press the ceiling away. Thigh presses away. Right thigh presses away. You can keep your left leg bent like this, or you can start straightening your left leg and try to tack your left thigh down to your mat. Right thigh presses away, left thigh presses away, and down. And then we'll bend that leg. Interlace your fingers behind the belly of your left hamstring. Push your thigh away from you. By the way, your hamstrings love having the hands pressing into the bones. Yeah. And then press your left foot up to the ceiling, optional. And straighten your right leg if you'd like. You still get benefit on the earlier variations. It's just what feels good to you and your body. Try to make yoga accessible to everyone. Connecting with your breath. Yoga means to unite. And then when you connect with your breath and your movements, man oh man, sure does feel good. And then we'll release. Now we'll do a nice spinal twist. It's called windshield wiper. Take the feet, your feet to the edges of your mat, and you can take your arms out like in cactus, root your shoulders down, your elbows down. And take both knees off to the left and turn your gaze to the right. Nice little easy twist. Come on up through center. And knees off to the right, and gaze off to the left, left shoulder. You try to anchor down if possible, or go in that direction. And come back up, and take it back to the first side. And now if you'd like, you can pick up your left foot and place it on top of your right thigh area, close to your knee, and this just adds a little extra juice to the pose. So your right hip is extending away from your torso. Up through center. And one more time off to the right. And you can pick up your right foot, place it on your right thigh to help you. Press your left thigh down. Stretch your gaze to the left and your shoulder to the left. Inhale, come back up. And now please stretch long in both directions. Point your legs, stretching out the tops of your legs. Flex your feet, extending through your hamstrings and your calves, and then point and flex. And then arms down along your side. Lift up your shoulder blades one more time so your shoulders can open, let your palms come open, let your legs fall open. For one of our favorite Sanskrit words, Shavasana, corpse pose. This is where your body can assimilate all the benefits of your practice. It's a very important part of your yoga practice, Shavasana. If you have time, you can stay longer, or please bend your one leg, bend your other leg. And slowly roll to your right side. Rest your head on your right arm. And then to keep the nice, heavy, yogic, calm feeling, let your legs be heavy as you use your arms to press you back up to seated. Come back often and practice backbends. From my heart to yours, namaste.